think the most important thing to share here is what is the trend of property market, how it's going to behave for the next 2-3 years. If you look at, I think a lot of people don't understand that the property market is very related to actually the banking sector. Because most of them buy property because there's a banking financing of properties. I think since 2011, I think the measure actually came in into the, in force. You see, you look at the housing price index, actually it went up to 2012. Then after that, I think we actually start to soften towards the last 3 years. The reason is because the banking side is tightening the belt. In fact, the first tightening in terms of policy is actually the enforcement of third house 70% and the borrowing in terms of debt service ratio up to 60% of gross pay, now revised to 50%. I think last weekend you see another tightening, which is actually the central bank shortening from 45 years of the tenor of the loan to 35 years. Last time when you are young, you have a lot of advantage because you can borrow longer so that your installment is lower. By this shortening, your repayment is higher. So that actually cut the affordability of buying higher value houses. So with the general income of 5,000-6,000, last time you can buy up to 400,000 of houses. Price. Now you can only buy 300,000 because of that effect. Next. So if you look at the also the approval rates, because of this tightening, in fact, yesterday during our property meeting, we actually started even our own sales. The approval rates of the purchasers who actually intended to buy compared to our own study, is actually out of 10, you only have about 4.5 to 5% approval. That means there is a rejection rate of 50%. Why? Because of the tightening of the credit. So you can actually see, you know, the approval rate has actually dropped to 50%, which is in line with what we have studied on even our own project. So I think in terms of yield, you can also, because of the price has actually gone up the last 3 years, in fact, went up quite high the last 3 years. That's why, because of the renter doesn't go as high in coincidence and in coincide with the price hike. So the yield has actually come down quite significantly from last time about 6.5 to now about 3.7 to 4%. So that is also something that I think a lot of investors are looking at, whether the price is right. But let me assure you one thing. As long as the location is good, during 97, I think EJ's price has not gone down. After the recession, the price went even higher than the last hike. So location, population, and also one critical thing you have to study is if that location is very jammed, that means that it's a bad location. If that location is not jammed, that means wrong location. Because when you buy property, you need population. If there's no population, means nobody will rent from you. You want to sell, or nobody will buy. So that is the location. So don't blame the jam. That is some actually interrelation between the jam and also the property price. So I think right now, if we have started, I think we have done study what is the best assets to invest. So if you look at the student population, there's a lot of growth since 2002. The foreign students is about 27,000. Right now, already exceeding 90,000. In fact, in Malaysia, there is no such thing as student accommodation, a specialized talent student accommodation. I think everyone who sits here understand that because some of you come in from our station or overseas, you can't get like what other institutions are doing in UK, Australia, or US, when a property management company come in with student accommodation, specialized housing. So this is something that I think it is good to look at, because the return is higher than the normal market. In fact, the return is about 6%. Now the students are being charged per head, which is, especially in Grand Valley, the rate is still good. So why Malaysia has been a center of attraction for foreign students? If you look at the study, I think we have the cheapest in terms of spending, in terms of fees, including the accommodation. I think we rank the lowest among all compared to other foreign universities, only 9,000 as an average cost to study here. So I think this has been proven, because we have launched our project, Just Resident, which is actually we are calling a facility management company. We are going to do this as a specialized student accommodation for all the education groups near to our project, which is, I think, in Subang and also EJ. In fact, we have done a preliminary count of the population, using about 150,000 students in these two locations. So actually, Just Resident almost sold. We only have another 10 units left. And we have just launched another block of G Resident, which is actually also for student accommodation. It is a very specialized feature, where normal condo has been redesigned in terms of what of furnishing it for student housing. So in terms of yield, as I mentioned, student is still the best yield. And in terms of this chart, not only Malaysia has this representation that the student accommodation is a very high yield kind of investment at 6%, even as compared to all other properties. But a similar chart I've studied in UK, actually published by Ernst & Young, the top asset class in terms of investment give the best yield is still student accommodation, and the market is very big, to about 150 billion pounds in the whole world. So I think because of that, we even come up with a special brand called PEP, Property Education Partnership, in the sense that this will be the first time where a developer put education together with property, and I think because of that, the yield will be better, and also the other thing, you put in the management where the investor do not need to manage the asset, he will actually manage the asset, and also rent up for